Here's a common problem that large enterprises have. On one hand, business users are the ones that know exactly how to make as much impact as possible on the entire organization. On the other hand, they lack the resources, the tools, the capabilities to act on their own. They are waiting for somebody from IT or somebody from the development team to solve their problem. And of course, IT cannot cover the requirements of all of the different business units. Low-code, no-code has really enabled in recent years those business users to solve their own problems, to address their own needs and accelerate business growth. People from HR, from marketing, from sales, from finance are building applications, building automations on top of business data, on top of Microsoft and Salesforce and ServiceNow, and accelerating their business. And we are actually seeing a growth of between 10x and 100x more applications being built by those business users. Of course, the problem is that business users are not security professionals. And so they end up making lots of mistakes that can introduce a bunch of security risk to the enterprise. In this talk, we're going to take an attacker's perspective on low-code, no-code and understand just how pervasive an attack could be when targeting low-code, no-code and hitting the enterprise. We're going to see how hackers can take advantage of misconfigurations and mistakes being done by business users in order to get in the enterprise. And of course, the idea here is to understand how, as defenders, we can build things in the right way. We can provide guardrails for those business users so they can remain productive and solve their business problems without introducing new risks to the organization.